Welcome gamers, Hazardor here, and today I'm bringing you a future legends squad builder. These guys are all over like 30 years old, and I really believe that these guys will get a legend card in FIFA next year, the year after, or a FIFA in the future. First off in goal, I haven't actually bought this guy, so I'm gonna have to use his concept player card. It is none other than Casillas. You know, he's an absolute legend for Real Madrid, and I'm pretty sure none of you would argue that this guy doesn't deserve to have a legend card. He's just an absolute tank in goal. Took a step down in his career slightly by going to Porto, but Real Madrid didn't want him anymore, so you know, he has to move on. But anyway, he definitely deserves a legend card. Now moving on to the first centre-back, it's actually John Terry. This guy is probably one of the best centre-backs the Premier League has ever had. Chelsea legend, you know, he's their captain, he's been their captain for so long. He's just the leader at the back, there's no doubt about it. Now coming in as the other centre-back is one of my favourite centre-backs ever, is Nemanja Vidic. Being a Manchester United supporter, I imagine you guys know exactly why I love this guy. He's just been a warrior at the back, played with a heart on his sleeve all the time, and always gave his all for the club. No matter if he was injured or whatever, he always gave 110%. His partner, who played a lot of games next to him, is Patrice Evra, another Manchester United legend. Very loyal player, very consistent, he very rarely made mistakes, and he's just an all-round. You can't really hate Patrice Evra, can you? Even if you don't support Manchester United, you have to respect what he's done for the game. Now moving on to right back, I've actually had a left back put in there because didn't have any, and I went for John Terry's partner, Ashley Cole. Both achieved tremendous stuff at Chelsea, obviously. You know, they won so much things, Champions League, Premier Leagues, FA Cups, you name it, they've won it. Ashley Cole sort of took a step down in his career, but of course, if Chelsea don't want him, he has to take a step down, doesn't he? Now, moving on to my centre midfielder, it is Lampard. Lampard won a lot with John Terry and Ashley Cole, and these guys really do, they are Chelsea, aren't they? As soon as you think about these players, you think about Chelsea. It doesn't matter if he went on loan to Man City or whatever, Lampard is Chelsea through and through. Now moving on to another centre midfielder, he's actually got a CDM card, it is Steven Gerrard. There's been a lot of comparisons between Gerrard and Lampard throughout the years, who's been better, who's got the best goals, who's been the better leader, you know, that sort of stuff, but I think all that aside, you have to agree that these guys have both done so much for their club, especially Gerrard. He's done so much for Liverpool, he's probably the best player Liverpool's ever had, so you really have to respect him for that. Now moving on to the other centre midfielder, the guy nobody in football can actually hate is Andrea Pirlo. Absolute legend, no doubt about it. You just have to love Pirlo. He's just got such a good style of playing football. He's got that really high passing on FIFA. His free kicks are good and he just plays, he makes the game look so easy. Now moving on to centre attacking midfielder, I've put a centre forward in there and it goes to Totti. Not the most popular player on FIFA, obviously because of his low pace, but you have to agree that this guy is, he's just an example to everybody. An example to everybody that you do not need to constantly go for clubs with a lot of money. Totti stayed with Roma for all his life. He's had big offers from other clubs. I think Real Madrid were after him at one point. I think Manchester City also wanted him. He just rejected contracts, didn't listen to them at all, stuck with Roma, and you have to respect him for that. What a player he's been for Roma, man. What a player. Now moving on to my first striker, it's actually another ex-Chelsea legend, is Didier Drogba. I think we all have to agree that he deserves a legend card as well. He's one of those strikers who's just strong, who's very good at headering the ball, and he can also finish it, can't he? He can finish almost anything, and he's just a beast of a player. Definitely deserves a legend card. No doubt about it. Now moving on to the last player in the team, it has to be Miroslav Klose. In my opinion, he's actually not achieved a lot at club level, but for Germany, you just can't doubt what he's achieved, can you? This guy's the all-time top goal scorer in the World Cup, and you don't get that by luck, do you? To achieve that goal, he recently defeated Ronaldo, the Brazilian Ronaldo's record of most goals in a World Cup. If you don't deserve a legend card for that, I don't know what it is. But anyway, guys, thank you for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe for more.